Hello everyone, today I am going to show you how to make a mandala. For this, we need one pencil, compass, scale and eraser. Put your pencil into the compass and open it as wide as you can that it can cover the whole page. I am not covering the whole page because I have to extend my mandala. So here I am. Now for the smaller circle, you have to open the compass exactly half for the one you have opened for the bigger circle. For example, if the bigger circle radius is 8 cm, so the smaller circle radius should be 4 cm. It should be exactly half. So I am making a smaller circle. So here it is my smaller circle. Now I am considering this circle as a smaller circle, and each and every circle which I am going to make now is to be considered as a new circle. So take any point on the smaller circle and make a circle. The compass distance should be the same as for the smaller circle. For example, I have taken the radius is 8 cm of bigger circle, small circle is 4 cm, and the new circle radius is also 4 cm. You have to keep that in mind, otherwise proper shape will not come. Now where the smaller circle and the new circle is meeting, at that point we will put our compass and make a new circle. We will continue this procedure . Now you can see that our first layer of all the new circles have been completed. This can be, you can see that we have achieved one flower in the smaller circle. So when we achieve a small flower in the smaller circle, then we can assume that our first layer of circles have been completed. Now we will make the second layer of the circles. For that, what we have to do is we have to find the middle of the section this. Of this section we have to find the middle. I am using a scale and I am marking the middle point. This is my middle point. Now I am going to again make the circle from this point. And we are going to do the same procedure where this new circle and the smaller circle is meeting. We will again put the compass there and we'll make our another circle. You have to take care of one thing, that the grip of your compass should be strong. And yes, there is a very high probability that you will confuse that which is your new circle and which is your smaller circle, and where they are meeting, there is a high probability that you are going to get confused. And for the thing that when you will know that all the layer, the whole layer of the circle is been completed, is when you will reach at one point and you see that you are not able to make any new circle, then you know that the process has been completed. In this, I have used only two layers of circles. In my previous post, I have completed the four layers of the circles in the same way. So it's up to you how many layers of circles you want to have. Beyond this, there's a probability of getting confused with the starting and the ending point of the circle. So I prefer for the newcomers that they should stop at the two layers, and then with practice they should go for third layer of circles and the fourth layer of the circle.